Good morning, Hadwen Park Church and friends. It's Confirmation Sunday, and it's Pentecost Sunday. I hope you're wearing red. If COVID had not arrived, we would have been confirming these six young people last year on Pentecost Sunday. So some of the service today is filmed from last year and the final confirmation liturgy this year. It's cobbled together and really reflects how long this took and how we stayed together for 2 years to make this happen. We hope that grandmas and grandpas are watching, siblings, cousins, and friends. We hope that you can have parties to celebrate this achievement of your children soon, if not this afternoon. Yesterday, Maurice and I delivered red bags to all of the confirmands' homes. In it was their confirmation certificate, their membership certificate, a pledge card. The deacons framed their favorite church song, and they can hang the words of that song on the wall of their room for now, for college, and maybe for the rest of their lives. Some of you sent sweet, encouraging cards to them, and they were placed in that bag. The stoles you will see them wear today signifies a serving ministry and is also a gift from you, their church. We truly did cobble this service together, but I believe that the patchwork is exquisite. So if family and friends are not watching with you right now, please make sure that you share this service today and next week. By the way, next week is Children's Sunday, and if you remember the Christmas pageant by Pastor Sarah, you will not wish to miss this. Also, invite others. It's a wonderful way to evangelize, to share the story of who Hadwen Park Congregational Church is. Guess what? There's even better news. We plan to worship together in person on June 13th.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Pastor Sarah will send out the ways in which we will see each other and stay safe. I'm not going to talk about those and wait for her comprehensive email, but please mark it on your calendar. And Charlie McMillan, you can't worship on Saturday afternoons so that you can sleep in on Sunday anymore, because we can't imagine you not present in person with us. Read all emails and please watch the website for updates. So now I have an assignment for all of you folks who love to solve riddles and can see details easily. For example, like Jane Moyer, who tells me my stole is always crooked. Do you remember in kindergarten when you had to circle what was wrong with this picture? You know, the pumpkin was upside down and the other pumpkins were right side up. The bicycle had one wheel instead of two. So I challenge you, as observers of all things that are just plain wrong, and when you look at them, they bother you, make a list. Make a list today of all that is wrong with this morning's video. There will be so many more things that are right in spirit. The kids, their music, their smiles. But maybe there's a candle that's lit in one quote-unquote scene and not the next. Keep your eyes open. You might have to worship 20 times this morning. This is Confirmation Sunday. This is Pentecost Sunday. May we worship and celebrate in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hear the welcoming statement of Hadwen Park Congregational Church, United Church of Christ, as we prepare to worship. No matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, we seek to find a place for you here at 6 Clover Street, Worcester, Massachusetts, United States of America, planet Earth. We hope you find peace and uplift in our worship. Welcome to all who have no church home, to all who need strength, to all who want to follow Christ, to those with doubts, or those who do not believe at all. Welcome to new visitors and to old friends. Welcome to all who have been wounded or unwelcomed at any church, anywhere, anytime. Welcome to grandparents, to mothers, fathers, and single and partnered people. Welcome to people of all colors, cultures, abilities, sexual orientations, and gender identities. To old and young, to believers and questioners, and welcome to questioning believers. Let us prepare to worship God.
Hello, my name is Maurice Newman. I received asylum in March of this year. I am a teacher by profession, and I am very anxious to teach for the Worcester Public Schools. I consider myself to be incredibly young. Hence, I know I can become a valuable asset to the education system in this era when educational landscape is being rewritten. I have been co-teaching confirmation class with Pastor Judy, and nothing gives me more pleasure. As you can see, we're in our confirmation room, and this is our last confirmation class in March. I enjoy it so much and want to reassure you that your children will be Christian leaders in the next generation of the Church of Jesus Christ. Maddie has a great and quiet mind. I enjoy seeing her mad when she doesn't win at that Bible game, but she remains very calm when Jack annoys the life out of her. She is very serious in doing her assignments, unlike a few others who I will not mention. I am particularly impressed with Jacob Decatur. When we first met, he was a very quiet person who would not want to do anything publicly. Look at Jacob now. He can be very quiet. However, when he speaks with his deep voice and his serious questions, we see what a wonderful and kind young scout he is. He has an amazing sense of self and strength. Jared Symes knows his Bible well and can offer Bible stories when we come to deep ethical questions. He is not afraid to speak his mind, and I sincerely appreciate that. Jared is a real smarty pants. He loves his family and their support of all his life's activities. Roxy is a deep thinker. I have no doubt she will be a church musician and maybe a preacher like her Nana. Once she gets going, she's also very funny. Roxy also listens to the sermons, but is quick to say she doesn't know what it meant. Tyler is smart. He pays a lot of attention to the services, including sermons, and has a unique perspective on things. He has a dry sense of humor and a very kind spirit. He is remarkably polite. Tristan is a man of justice. He cares about those who need help. He also loves music and is said to be a great singer and dancer. He seems shy, but he is not. Jack Bullock is a stitch. Jack always wants to know what Jesus would do in issues of social concern and politics. He loves music and takes the award for being the class clown with great pleasure. They are all wonderful. We plan to meet throughout the summer, and the class has asked to meet weekly. I have watched these kids become very close, and they miss each other. They also talk a lot about how much they miss all of you. Yes. They miss the choir, the congregational singing, coffee hour. Who would have thought all that meant so much to the kids? But most of all, I think they miss pizza at confirmation class. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to share my love for Christ as your confirmation teacher. God's richest blessing to all of you.
Thank you. Psalm 119, 9 through 16, the New Revised Standard Version. How can young people keep their way pure? By guarding it according to your word. With my whole heart, I seek you. Do not let me stray from your commandments. I treasure your word with my heart, so that I may not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Lord. Teach me your statutes. With my lips, I declare all the ordinance of your mouth. I delight in the way of your decrees as much as in all riches. I will meditate on your precepts and fix my eyes on your ways. I will delight in your statutes. I will not forget your word. The Hebrew scripture for the Christian people. Amen.
I'm Jared Sims of the 2020 Confirmation Class, reading the Gospel lesson. John verses 1 through 10. Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for himself, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls on his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits. But the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters me by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it more abundantly." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, Hadwen Park. I'm Tyler Aaron, part of the 2020 Confirmation Class. I first came to HBC when Jack Bullock invited me on a mission trip. I started going to church since I had to be there for meetings and fundraisers, but I stayed because of the people, the environment, the songs, the choir, coffee hour, our pastors, and so much more. I had never gone to church consistently before HBC, and I find it to be a truly spectacular and special place. I'm so glad that I get to be a part of it. I find this church to be a gift from God to me, because before HBC, I wasn't so sure about God, and I wasn't so sure I had a connection with he or she, but now I feel differently. Pastor Judy wanted us to say how we felt about not having Confirmation Sunday, and I'm sad because it was going to be on my birthday, and I just felt that that made it a little more special. But on the other hand, I'm excited now that I get to have a few more months with my confirmands in Confirmation class. And now I have something to look forward to for when we get back to church. The things I miss the most from HBC are definitely coffee hour, because although I didn't go every week, whenever I did, someone would always say hi. I also miss in the mornings when we greet everyone, say hello, shake hands. I took it for granted because now the whole perspective of saying hello and shaking someone's hand is a lot different. I really miss confirmation class and hanging out with everyone and playing games, and just talking, and being able to see each other. It's different now that everything's online. I really took it all for granted. I truly miss everyone at HBC, and I really can't wait to get back to everyone.
Hi, HBC. My name's Maddie Hernandez, if you didn't know, and I'm a sophomore at Grafton High School. And I'm also part of the 2020 confirmation class. So I originally came to HPC when I was really little. My two aunts, Joyce and Barbara Berg, and my great-grandmother, Mary Jane Gustafson, they came to the church, and that's sort of where we started going to church. And then as I got older, we kind of got a lot more busy on the weekends and stuff like that. So we eventually just stopped coming to church a lot. And But I came back to do my confirmation, so that's why I'm here today. And so I definitely miss a lot of things about HPC. It's such a nice and like happy place. I really miss going there every Sunday. But some of the things that I definitely miss the most are confirmation classes and getting pizza and playing the Bible game during confirmation class, which is Pastor Judy and or Maurice will pick a random like spot in the Bible and then tell us to find it, and whoever says the first word of that line gets a point. And I definitely miss being ahead the entire game and then putting it all on the line at the last question and losing every single time. I definitely also miss seeing all of my friends at HPC. I still talk to a lot of them, but it's just not the same without being able to see them. I definitely miss seeing Farouk and Fahad. Even though they're not like part of the confirmation class, I definitely miss seeing them every weekend and all of their pranks that they play on me. I really miss Maurice and Pastor Judy like teaching confirmation, because we still have like Zoom meetings for confirmation, but it just doesn't feel the same. I definitely miss hearing the choir too. I never thought that like that would make such a difference, but when we have like virtual service, I definitely miss like hearing the entire choir, and I always took that for granted, I think. But things that have been like helping me stay close to God or keep like thoughts about that in mind are I go for runs or walks with my dogs, and it's nice to like get out of the house and kind of just set your mind free. So I think if you have the opportunity to do that, it really helps, and it makes your outlook on the whole day feel a lot better. So that's definitely helped me get through the day and be a little bit more happy. I feel like that's helped me grow closer to God, because it gives me time to like think about everything and just sort of step away from like all of the like craziness in the world and just be like in your own little like happy like bubble, I guess, and be on your own for a little bit. One of my favorite confirmation memories is probably when we went on our retreat in Cape Cod. So some of the funny things from that trip were we like last minute like packed everybody into the back of Trish Sims' like minivan. And I know that Jack and Tristan both had to share rides down and back, sitting in the way back of her minivan with me and Roxy. And they definitely did not want to do that. So I feel bad for them, but not really. And when we got there, it was really fun. Like the whole trip was really fun. And we got to like sing songs and meet like kids from other churches, which was nice. And we had like these little like houses like down there, like each like group had their own little house. And so me and Roxy and Trish Sims, we had this entire little house like all to ourselves. So like me and Roxy were just like exploring the whole thing. And like, I really liked that trip because it helped the whole confirmation class like really come together, and we're now really close with each other. And it helped me make a new friend. I definitely like got a lot closer to Roxy during that trip, which I really am grateful for. And also, it was like literally freezing, and Tristan decided to jump into the ocean. So that was definitely a highlight of the trip. But yeah, a lot of like fun and like memories that brought us closer together during that trip helped us to be like a really tight group, which I'm like really grateful for. So yeah, so have a nice weekend. Bye.
Hi, I'm Jack Bullock. I'm a freshman at Tantasco High School, and I'm also part of the confirmation class at HPC. So I've been going to the church my whole life. I'm sure a lot of you guys know my grandparents. My grandfather is Jim Gemma. He's the moderator. And my grandmother is Stephanie Gemma. She is the financial secretary. So obviously, the church has been a huge part of my family. My grandparents would come every Sunday morning when I was little and bring me to church. And I didn't really like it. I thought it was boring. So I'm more of a chore. So eventually, I kind of just didn't go that much. It was up until when the mission trip last year came around, and we, you know, I thought I always loved helping people, so why not give it a try? and I went on the trip, and I, you know, got closer to a lot of the people there, and also got closer to God and the church there. So after that, I started going to church more, and then the confirmation class came around. So, you know, I kind of just did it. I didn't really know what to expect. Thought maybe it'll be boring. Maybe it might be fun. Who knows? And then, you know, it finally came around, and it was a lot of fun. So one of my favorite memories in confirmation is probably the retreat we went on back in, I think it was November, when, and that was, it kind of, you know, brought us all closer together. Before that, you know, we all knew each other, but that was, you know, pretty much it. But after that, we all are now pretty close friends. So, you know, some of the things I miss at the church are getting up and shaking hands with everyone every morning. It'll be a long time till we do that again, if we ever get to do that again. I miss hearing the choir sing that, and getting up to sing with everybody else too. That was a lot of fun. And so yeah, just here to say I miss you guys, most of you. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Bye.
Everybody falls sometimes. Gotta find the strength to rise from the ashes and make a new beginning. Anyone can feel the ache. You think it's more than you can take, but you're stronger, stronger than you know. Don't you give up now. The sun will soon be shining. You gotta face the clouds to find the silver lining. I've seen dreams that move the mountains. Hope that doesn't ever end, even when the sky. Hearts become brand new. That's what faith can do. It doesn't matter what you've heard. Impossible is not a word. It's just a reason for someone not to try. Everybody's scared to death when they decide to take that step out on the water, but it'll be alright. Life is so much more than what your eyes are seeing. You will find your way if you keep believing. I've seen silent prayers get answered, broken hearts.
Hey, Hadwen Park. I'm Jacob Decatur. I originally came to Hadwen Park as a child because I grew up coming. I took a break, though, give or take a couple of years, to focus on school and other hobbies of mine. Ever since I joined Boy Scouts, though, I was urged by family members and friends of the church to come back and join confirmation class, which is why I'm here filming this video right now. We were supposed to do Confirmation Sunday, but thanks to the coronavirus, we're not able to do that. And yeah, that's a little bit annoying, but at least I don't have to do much schoolwork and I can focus on my hobbies such as playing video games and watching old movies on Disney Plus. But other than that, I hope you stay healthy and goodbye.
Hello, Hadwen Park Church. My name is Tristan St. Pierre. My parents are Mike and Joanne St. Pierre. I was born into Hadwen Park Church about 15 years ago, but my parents were members at the time. I am disappointed that we would not be able to attend Confirmation Sunday because I would have had a lot of fun with the rest of the confirmants. If we were able to go to church for Confirmation Sunday, I would have been up and ready to sing or play the saxophone. Now that Confirmation Sunday is virtual, it won't be as fun because I don't get to see my friends or the rest of the church. Hope that we can all meet soon and praise the Lord.
Hello, HPC. I'm Jared Sims of the 2020 Confirmation Class. I've been coming to HPC for as long as I can remember. My mom went when she was little, so I was baptized here and I've been coming ever since. I was really looking to being confirmed, but we'll have to wait. But as a plus, we get to stay with the group for a longer period of time. This year's confirmation has been a really great experience for me. Even when the year started, I feel like we were already a really close group of kids, and it's been really fun. We learn a lot every time we're together, and we have a lot of fun doing it. We play a bunch of fun games, and we even go on some really nice retreats. On the retreats, there's fun music, we go to the beach, and we make posters. I'm really excited to see all of you once I get back, and I really miss seeing you all and praying with you all and singing as a congregation.
Good morning. I'm Roxy Devlin. I am in the 2020 confirmation class. I grew up at Hadwen Park Church, and I was really hoping to finish confirmation in the church and celebrate in person with everyone. And I was hoping that I could play the piano or read scripture. So instead, we do it virtually. I enjoy the time we spend together laughing and joking around. I also enjoy the challenges of thinking about God and getting closer to Him in ways I never was. I really enjoyed the retreats we went on and wish we had more time together. I am grateful for Zoom and at least being able to connect with my friends. I miss seeing you all. Stay safe.
Friends in Christ, we are all received into the church through the sacrament of baptism. These young people before you, through prayer and study, they have found nurture and support in the midst of the family of Christ. They now are claiming their covenantal relationship with Christ and the members of this church. They are here for service to Jesus Christ, using the gifts which the Holy Spirit bestows. And so we say, God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. Said Jesus, if you love me, you will abide in love. These things have I spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be filled. Confirmants, do you desire to affirm your baptism into the faith and family of Jesus Christ? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you renounce the powers of evil and desire the freedom of new life in Christ? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you promise by the grace of God to be Christ's disciples, to follow in the way of our Savior, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to witness to the work and word of Jesus Christ as best as you are able? If so, say, I will with the help of God.
I will.
Do you promise, according to the grace given you, to grow in the Christian faith and to be a faithful member of this Church of Jesus Christ, celebrating Christ's presence and furthering Christ's mission in all the world? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Now, any in the congregation can join in as I ask the congregants what their beliefs are. Do you believe in God?
I
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit.
Shall we pray? Holy God, these are your children. Grant them love for others, joy in serving you, peace in disagreement, patience in suffering, kindness toward all people, goodness in evil times, faithfulness in temptation, gentleness in the face of opposition, self-control in all things. Strengthen them as we hold them in our arms and in our prayers for their ministry in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Jack Bullock, will you please come forward? God's message is near you. It's on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived, died, to raise from the dead, you'll be saved. And you will be a saving force in this world. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so welcome as a saint and member of this household of faith. Go now and serve the Lord. Amen. Jacob Decatur, will you please come forward? Jacob Decatur, God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach here. As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived, died, and was raised from the dead, you will be saved, and you, Jacob, will be a saving force in this world. Welcome as a saint and a member of this household of faith. Go now, Jacob, and serve the Lord. Roxy Demlin, will you please come forward? God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived and died and was raised from the dead, you'll be saved. And you will be a saving force in this world. Welcome as a saint and member of this household of faith. Go now and serve. Yeah. Maddie Hernandez, will you please come forward? Maddie, God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That's the word of faith that we preach. As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived and died and was raised from the dead, you'll be saved. And you know what? I know. You're going to be a saving force in this world. We welcome you as a saint and as a member of this household of faith. Go now and serve the Lord. Tyler Heron, will you please come forward? Tyler, God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach here at Hadwen Park.
As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived, died, and was raised from the dead, you'll be saved. And you, I know, will be a saving force in this world. Welcome as a saint and member in this household of faith. Go now, Tyler, and serve the Lord. Jared Sims, would you please come forward? Message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith. As you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representation of God on earth, who lived and died and was raised from the dead, you'll be saved, and you will be a saving force in this world. Welcome as a saint and member of this household of faith. Go now. I invite Tristan St. Pierre to come forward. Tristan, God's message is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we preach. And as you seek to follow Jesus, believing that Jesus was the most perfect representative of God on earth, who lived and died and was raised from the dead, you will be saved and be a saving force in this world. Welcome as a saint and a member of this household of faith. Go now and serve the Lord. Go hungry, grandma. Aw, grandpa.
Dear God, may we who are merely inconvenienced remember those whose lives are at stake. May we who have no risk factors remember those most vulnerable. May we who have the luxury of working from home remember those who must choose between preserving their health or making their rent. May we who have to cancel our trips remember those that have no safe place to go. May we who have the flexibility to care for our children when their schools close remember those who have no options. May we who are losing our margin money in the turmoil of the economic market remember those who have no margin at all. May we who settle in for a quarantine at home remember those who have no home. As fear grips our country, let us choose love. During this time, when we cannot physically wrap our arms around each other, let us yet find ways to be the loving embrace of God to our neighbors. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father and Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us for our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Hello, my name is Jacob Decatur. I'm in the 2020 confirmation class, and I'm also a scout at Troop 22 here at Hadwen Park. We have learned in confirmation that all the bills are paid with money that is received through the offering basket on Sunday morning, the bank checks that are sent to the church each month, and the checks that are mailed in when somebody can't come to church. So, since we can't come to church due to coronavirus, Alan Delaire, the guy who pays the bills, has to hope that all of you remember to send in your checks. We also learned that the church budget each year is based on what you all pledge. What has to be paid from the budget are all the church expenses, salaries, the confirmation books, heat, lights, cleaning, supplies, music for the choir, phones, Sunday school supplies, etc. I enjoy confirmation and scouts, so I hope all of you do your best to pay the bills for my generation too. I learned that Hadwen Park does not have a lot of money in the bank, Some churches have had benefactors whose money have been invested, and the church can use that money at difficult times. Not HPC. We live from one offering plate to the next, from one bunch of mail to the next. Pastor Judy and Pastor Sarah also want to make sure that you know, if you have lost your job or are having financial difficulties, please spend your pledge money on food and rent and talk to them for help. Please come to our food pantry, which is every Wednesday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Don't forget the Benevolence Fund, food pantry account, and the LGBT asylum account. So I hope you all can dig deep and do your best.
Good morning, I'm Tristan St. Pierre. I was baptized in this church, have gone to Sunday school, vacation Bible school, youth groups, and mission trips. I'm in the 2020 confirmation class. I just want to tell you all that I miss you. It is time to take the morning offering. Please keep track of our financial situation by watching the chart that Stephanie Gemma updates for us weekly. We are in a really good shape because a few people paid their pledge for the whole year, because some of you are sending a little extra to cover for those who have lost jobs. Food pantry and benevolence are being strained due to increased need at this time. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you that you have plans for me that are for my good and your glory. You said, give, and it will be given to you. For in the same measures as you give, it will be given to you again. We give to you today as a response to your goodness to us. We ask that you receive your offerings and continue to supply all our needs. May your peace be in our hearts, your grace be in our words, your love be in our hands, and your joy be in our souls. In your mighty name, amen.
We wait upon you now for our morning offering.
Thank you.
Benediction. The way is long. Let us go together. The way is difficult. Let us help each other. The way is joyful. Let us share it. The way is Christ's, for Christ is the way. Let us follow. The way is open before us. Let us go with the love of God, the grace of Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May heaven's face shine upon you and give you peace, now and forevermore. Amen.